Hey there, it's Catherine from Skydive Vibes, and partnering up with the CSPA, we are bringing you this video series about the Canadian way to become a solo skydiver. So in this video, we're gonna explain the progression path to become a solo skydiver, whether it's the progressive freefall program or the gradual freefall program. Let's start! Let's talk about the progressive freefall program. The PFF program is the most common in Canada and offers a defined progression towards achieving the solo certificate. PFF courses consist of multiple level jumps to develop different skills. Here I'm going to cover the general CSPA PFF program, which has about 10 jumps. And you'll train closely with certified instructors. First, you'll get 3 to 4 hours of theory in a class. You'll then learn the basics like how to fly, how your gear works, how to react if an unusual situation happens. But basically the goal is to give you all that you need so that you can have a safe skydive every time. Now you'll be ready for your first jump, and for that jump you'll jump with 2 instructors holding you during the freefall. So the goal during your first jump will be to fly stable and keep your heading straight while always being aware of your altitude. You'll then practice your deployment procedure, and by 5,000 feet, you'll get to pull your parachute. Remember that you'll have 2 instructors by your sides, so if something happens and you're not able to deploy your canopy, it can happen for the first jump, they will be there to help you deploy it. Once under canopy, you'll be assisted by an instructor for your canopy flight and landing. In your second jump, you'll still have 2 instructors jumping with you, but then in freefall, one of them may release you to come in front of you and give you some basics recommendation to adjust your position. You may also be able to practice some turns. Here again, of course, you'll be required to deploy your own canopy, and still you'll have an instructor there to assist you if something happens, but at that stage, you should start to do it by yourself. Here again, under canopy, you'll be assisted by an instructor if needed, but at that step, you should be comfortable in doing your landing by yourself. Note that all of those steps are depending on the skills of the skydivers. So some may go faster, but others can have to redo some of those steps to make sure the skills needed are really mastered. Now, up to your third jump. This will be your first experience of a solo flight. At that stage, both of your instructors may release their grips from you to see how you fly on your own. Again, you'll get to practice your deployment procedure to see if you can remain stable and keep your heading doing so. At the right altitude, you'll then be required to deploy your canopy by yourself. Now, for your fourth jump, you'll jump with only 1 instructor. He or she will assist you to exit the plane stable. You'll then fly solo most of your freefall. You'll then be asked to do turns by your instructor. Same steps as before apply for your deployment and landing. Your fifth jump is still done with only 1 instructor, but you'll get to exit the plane completely on your own. You'll be asked to do an unstable exit and to become stable in under 5 seconds. Again, the same steps apply for deployment and landing. The next jump is called the pre-solo jump because you'll still jump with an instructor, but you'll do the whole skydive all by yourself. The exit, the free fall, the canopy, and the landing. It's now time for your first solo jump. So the jump number 7 and 8 will be completely on your own without any instructor. So during those jumps, make sure to practice the required skills and maneuvers for you to complete your solo certificate. Your solo video jump is basically your practical exam. You'll be recorded for the full jump from the ground preparation to the jump and landing. Usually you'll have a specific freefall routine to do to demonstrate the control of the skills needed for your solo certificate. Last but not least, your low altitude jump. This jump is there to practice a low level jump, or hop and pop as we call them. It is also a practice for a potential emergency exit where you would need to exit a malfunctioning plane at a lower altitude. During this jump, you'll have to exit the plane, become stable, and then deploy your canopy by 3,500 feet. You may notice that this jump can be particularly stressful because at this point, you are used to jump from a higher altitude. But in any case, relax and breathe. Once you experiment it, you'll notice that this altitude gives you enough time to deploy your canopy. There is also a variation of the progressive freefall program, which includes indoor skydiving in a wind tunnel as a first step. Again, this depends on the drop zone you are at. Starting with a wind tunnel introduction is very beneficial because then you can focus on your freefall skills without having the stress of the other elements of a skydive, like the exit, the canopy flight, and the landing. The main difference in that variation of progression is that you'll get to do a 20 minutes in the wind tunnel before going for your first skydive. Congratulations, you're now a solo skydiver, or almost. You just need to pass your theoretical exam in order to get your solo certification. Alright, so that was a progressive free fall program, the PFF, which is the most common in Canada. Again, stay tuned because in the next video, we will explain the second possible path for you to become a solo skydiver, the gradual free fall program. Interested in becoming a solo skydiver? Reach out to your local drop zone to book your course. You'll find the link in the description below. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video and blue skies.
The Canadian Sport Parachuting Association partnered with Skydive Vibes with the goal of demystifying the sport of skydiving and to share awareness of our sport. The goal of producing those videos is not to detail the exact progression of becoming a skydiver, but rather share some of the content and steps that you may go through as you advance. The exact progression may vary across the country and at different skydiving centers.